two tickets to see Benji.
Benji?
Yeah, it's Benji, little doggy.
I'm not sure if we're showing Benji tonight, sir.
Oh, well, how about Lassie?
No, not that one either.
How about her mama? What's that dog in the safe? But no, mama, mama? Do y'all have any dog movies playing at all?
Not as far as I know.
Is there a race track here, guys? Oh, never mind. I swear he don't got Benji, don't got Lassie, don't got Mama Duke. What kind of theater is this?
Spooky Movie Television. I'm Dr. Sarcofiguy, the Ginger Rogers of Horror Host. The Ginger Rogers of Horror Host, you may ask? Well, you can ask, and I'll tell you. I'm the Ginger Rogers of Horror Host because I do everything that Fred Astaire does, but only ass backwards. That's right. And I even have a beauty mark. Oh, I'm lying. I don't have a beauty mark because I'm one great big beauty mark. That's right. I'm beautiful all over. You know what? In my spare time, I hang out with unattractive people and make them much more attractive by pretending that my figure is a beauty mark for them. And I put it on their faces just like this. Or this. Even this. And when I want to give them those cute little freckles across their face, I do this. Or this.
Dr. Sarcofiguy, I've missed you so much. Hello.
Oh, wait. There's something wrong with your makeup.
Oh my God, can you fix it?
Yes, I can.
Okay.
Hold tight. Here we go.
Please fix it.
Oh, you look better already.
I feel better already.
Yeah. I'm going to give you a little freckles. Hold tight.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, you look all even more better. I'll tell you. Oh, wait a minute. Let me give you a whole freckle face. There you go. Yeah, you better go to the movie while she's trying to figure this out.
Can you beautify my whole body?
Oh, Lord. Maybe I'll think about it after the movie.
Really?
Oh, yes.
Okay.
The movies we're going to see are sort of a spin on the Frankenstein mythos. We got Back to Life and Wolfman versus Frankenstein. That Frankenstein, not Frankenstein.
I just call him Frankie.
He just calls him Frankie. That's right. That's cute. Let me give it that whole freckle face. Okay, you go back to the movie, y'all. Go to the movie. Just go. Go. There you go. Full body freckle. Oh, boy, I'm working PG here.
He's alive! Alive! You brought me back to life. Okay. No, that's, you know what? That was fine. I was in heaven, surrounded by loved ones. Everything was perfect. And you brought me back to life. Good. No, that's good. Oh, look at that. I got somebody else's arms. Good for me. Yeah. That's great. I guess I should be concerned about those villagers outside with the torches, but I'm sure they're not here for me. Yeah. This is great. What is that? You know, I'm just... Is that... You know, I guess that's me, huh? I guess I'm a little ripe. Hooey. Suppose it's not going to make me too, popular with the ladies, huh? So, have you got a woman for me? Have you? I mean, you did bring me back to life. I figured the least you could do is, you know, give me a woman. Okay, yeah, I see. You brought a dead girl back to life, even though there's plenty of live women walking around, some of them desperate enough even to date me, you've decided to reanimate a dead one. Not the choice that I would have made, but, well, there you have it. So, what's your name, sweetie? I think we should see other people.
You're now watching Spooky Movie Television.
Be looking into that one's story. Looks right suspicious to me.
What are you up to? Does your headmistress know where you are?
Miss Galloway sent us to get her medicine.
Well then, get about it. Keep your hands out of other people's pockets. You won't find what you're looking for here.
And a Dover Milo.
Why does Leto always get to hold the loot? She's the oldest.
And because Miss Galloway won't buy us things, and I know what we need.
Can I have the pictures?
Here you go, Sprout.
Oh, sorry, dearie. I can't seem to find my legs tonight.
We better get back.
What was that? Sounds far away.
Sounds like it's all around us. Come on!
Isn't that the woman from the Scabbard Inn? Going.
This is my home.
What's your name?
I was never given one.
Don't you have a mother and a father?
Only those who are born have mothers and fathers. I was assembled from the dead. And given life by a man of science.
So you're an orphan too? Did you read all of these?
Yes. Those books are my friends. It's just Yip and I now.
I need to find Milo and Eddie to see if they're okay. We orphans have to stick together. Will you help me?
The woods are not safe for us or your friends. But I will help.
This is where we first saw it. I think they went that way.
We must be careful. The wolf's hour lasts until first light.
Thank you.
Peter, we're up here. Come on down from there.
We were beginning to think I got you. We've been up here all night.
Miss Galloway will be looking for us. What will we tell her if she's still awake? If we're lucky, she won't even know we've been gone. Ah! No, no, he's okay. He's a friend.
We should keep moving. The woods won't be safe until morning. I have been aware of its presence in the woods for the past 3 months. It is only a beast by night. By day, it lives as a man. But which man, I do not know.
We saw the dead woman last night with a man from the Scabbard Inn.
She left with him, and then she ended up dead.
Well, let's start with him, then.
Well, hello there, Lita. Boys? Come to get Mrs. Galloway's medicine, have you?
No, thank you, Mr. Talbot. We only wanted to ask you about the silver-haired man who stays in the room upstairs.
You must mean Mr. Ridley. Strange chap he is.
How's that?
He's usually out with the ladies all night. Never in before dawn. When he is here, he's in his room clacking away on his writing machine.
He's a writer?
Yeah, of adventure books about all kinds of strange places. Took a look at one myself once. It was about a young couple cursed by an old gypsy woman. Gave me the willies indeed.
It has to be him. What do we do now?
We can't be sure it's him. We need to test him somehow.
How are we going to do that?
I have read of a plant called Wolfsbane that is said to bloom even when the stem is cut near a wolfman. I know a place where it grows.
What do we do if it blooms?
We will need pure silver to kill it.
All right, if you go and collect the wolfsbane, Milo, you and Eddie try and round up as much silver as you can find. Knives, silverware, canes, anything.
What are you going to do?
Someone needs to keep an eye on him until you get back.
Looking for me, little girl?
Don't hurt me.
I wouldn't hurt a little girl.
Please, mister, please let me go.
I can't. I can't let you go on thinking that this is all my fault. We have a little while yet before nightfall. I'm going to tell you a story. After the war, I spent my family's money traveling the world. Fate led me to a gypsy girl named Esmeralda.
We have to be careful. Yanko will get suspicious.
I'd rather your husband did find out about us. We could put an end to all this sneaking about.
You would take me with you?
One night, her husband did find us together.
Yanko!
There you are, you filthy harlot! You bring shame onto me and my family! You and your lover can keep each other company in hell!
Thank you.
You are the cause of all this heartache.
I was only...
Since you behave like an animal, then you shall live as one. Every night until your death.
So you see, what can I do?
You can let me go.
I'm sorry. I can't do that.
Get back to town. Run as fast as you can.
What about you?
It'll be all right. Go!
Later!
What happened to you?
What did you get?
We've got these.
Good, we have to hurry. Come on.
Should go.
No, he's just like us. He has no mother and father. We have to stick together. He is alive.
Doesn't that hurt?
Yes, it does.
I can't get close enough to make them walk.
Let me have it.
Is it over?
Yes. The curse is lifted.
You saved my life twice.
I had to. We orphans need to stick together.
Thank you. Just this week, we were at a funeral together. And a young girl was there. And I said, do you know who this is? This is Count Gore Duval, the host of Creature Feature. And she said, who?
You don't seem to be listed in our records. Did you get a proper permit for this erection?
What?
One Saturday night, I was flipping the channels and I saw him, and I just had this amazing crush on him.
He wasn't Cal Gore Duvall when I first saw him. He was Captain 20, he had pointy ears, page boy, Louise Brooks hairstyle kind of thing going on, and his really interesting jumpsuits.
I remember I got my Captain 20 card when I entered the contest to win a Herbie the Love Bug. And I didn't win it, but, you know, that's the way that goes.
Cap 20 was the man who had the gerbil races. It's unthinkable today.
Hey, how long have you been collecting these beer cans?
Oh, about 2 or 3 years.
But no, you know, but hey, it's the 70s, man.
It just keeps coming back. It's been around since the Stone Age. It was the storytellers that sat around a fire. They still tell the stories of ooh, and they scare each other.
The people want this. The time is right. There's all this creativity going on.
Oh,
you're expecting something less than a full studio?
Oh, you are killing me!
Tonight, I bring you a little bit of everything for everyone. In addition to our classic for tonight,
Count Gore Duvall, Count Gore Duvall, blah!
I hope he continues for forever and as long as he can, you know, keep it up. But it seems like, you know, he's enjoying it now just as much as he ever did. And I'm happy for that. I'm real grateful to see that he's still out there.
That's the way you do it, kids.
You're looking at Spooky Movie Television.
When the moon is full and high.
What are you supposed to be? A werewolf?
No one is safe. Not man, not woman, not child.
Is somebody out here?
Animal instinct fueled by a drug-induced rage.
Dude, you just smoked a lot of PCP.
Werewolf on PCP.
Bastard. So how do we stop this thing?
Try silver bullets and detox.
How do I know? I didn't write the fucking book.
Unstoppable ruthlessness sprinkled with angel dust.
It's not just dust.
Werewolf on PCP.
Coming soon to a theater near you.
Seeing werewolves on PCP. Isn't that something?
Oh, this is what our baby's going to look like. Can I hold him?
Oh, Lord, if our baby's going to look like that, what are we going to call little baby ugly?
No, he's fussy like Daddy.
Oh, well, yes, Daddy. No, I'm not the Daddy. That's, no,
you're
no,
the daddy.
No, that's a...
We're going to get a test.
You, oh, no. Oh, go to hell, Jess. Oh, we'll get to that in a second. Anyway, the next movie you're going to be seeing is directed by the same person that directed Werewolves on PCP. His name is James Branscome. And the movie is called We All Scream. And I do feel like screaming right now. Because if my baby's going to look like this, I don't want to have to put him on a leash.
Don't we make a cute family? You're gonna be a good daddy.
Oh, God, I gotta have him dipped. Spayed and neutered.
Thank you. you are watching spooky movie television. Try not to be scared.
Choked on your mother's milk, fucker.
You cut that shit right now. Detective Strong asked you a question. I suggest you answer it.
Answer it? I don't answer to any authority.
Like hell you don't.
Or any god.
Oh yeah? Well then you can answer to this. Wise ass.
Let me tell you something, you gutless piece of shit. If you don't start answering our goddamn questions, you're gonna be drawing straws in hell to see which end of you gets the devil first.
Talk to us, blind. Right now, you fucking freak.
My patience is wearing real thin, Mr. Blight.
You make me sick. You're pathetic.
This thing you people people call life is the biggest fucking disaster I could possibly imagine. You all waste day in and day out just throwing gas on the fire. Well, I don't want it. And it shouldn't be forced on anyone, especially innocent.
Innocent? You murdered an innocent.
I made a wrong right.
You blew the head off a defenseless child.
I saved a life a lifetime of misery.
And then you shot its mother point blank in the face before 10 witnesses in the supermarket security cam. You don't know fuck.
Sorry, Snake.
You don't
deserve
the time to get it now.
But when little piggies go to market, they not just find the all and everything. And as bacon it is, no questions asked.
Just like.
Could have watched her for hours. Never grown tired. Her smile. Her smell was like. I never wanted anything but her. A son. Nothing meant anything without them. And now, nothing does. I tried to understand. I've listened and I've bore into myself until I was kneeling bloody and beaten before the face of all meaning. It was bottomless. An abyss without light and without self-worth. And there was no answer to my prayers, not even an echo for my screams, no cure for my sickness, nothing. A killer has come and taken my family from me. He's even stolen my vengeance. I am beyond hope. Life is nothing but a killing machine and an engine of suffering. And death? Death is just a penalty for living. In a lifetime of torment for those of us left behind. I mean, I've asked myself minute by minute and day after day, why go on? Why fight when I can't even see the enemy coming? How do I keep focused when the world around me has gone absolutely goddamn insane? I don't even know what side I'm on anymore. The beast is here, you know. He's been waiting and watching, hungry for me to splinter and for me to crack. But he's not the only one. There's no up and there's no down when God and devil tear apart the man in between. There's just life. There's just people. There's just madness without end. Well, I've had my fill of despair. I'm a sample of reality. Cross-section of villain. And I can no longer decide which is the lesser evil. Heaven, hell, or humanity. So my compromise is no compromise. I'll keep my soul and my mind. But to the devil, I give something God will never possess. And with it, I give my pain. I choose to be mercenary. A vigilante for sense and reason. And I choose to be human no more.
Ah!
no more. Oh, isn't it just bizarre and intense? It just makes me just want to, like, take a bath.
Did you start our show without me?
Yes, dear. I started the show without you, and I thought that's how it's going to go. But now that you're here, I guess I have an idea. How about you give yourself a beauty mark? Just take your little finger and just keep yourself occupied by doing this all the time.
Oh, no, I like it when you do it.
Oh, really? Well, okay, I'll give you a beauty mark. How about I give you some dimples?
Okay.
Here you go. Here you go. Ooh, it's like... Look, it's like roasting a pretty girl on a spit, isn't it? It's a shame I just can't make it just kind of just roll forward. Anyway, we're going to leave you now with my charming dePest right here. But hey, listen. If it gets good, don't worry. We'll hug it out.
Oh, we're going to hug it out.
Oh, Lord, I feel like I'm on a bad wrestling match now. I need to be Ric Flair. Oh, here we go again with the hug. It's all for me. We gotta I'm just leaving. I'm just getting out of here. I can't take it anymore.